Okay, I'm mad as hell and I'm not going to take it anymore. No, no, I need a better intro than that. Hang on, let me make this really kind of 1980s. Here we go. I'm mad as hell and I'm not going to take it anymore. Boom. See, shit, that didn't work either. Fuck. Okay, let's do some music. See if maybe. Oh, this chick pisses me off too.
To me, it's just you're a writer.
What?
Go write.
Go write. Listen, Grey's Anatomy, private
this
practice
is a
person.
Moment.
This is not a moment.
Television right now.
Fuck
even
your
you have, like,
official teaser for rhymes teaching.
You can find
and that's racist too. Like, listen. Like, she would not have said that. Like, did you hear that? She's like, if you have five kids and you job, seriously, it's
down.
Racist.
If you can write and people can find your script, they will be free.
Or YouTube channel. Fuck you, Rhonda Rhymes. Shonda teaches.
If you can think of any.
Yeah, podcaster.
Almost as much.
Professional
as being a
podcaster.
Anything.
Like.
Go be it.
Okay, well, fuck that. I'm gonna go.
Can't think of anything else,
I'm gonna just go pour some sugar on some
us.
Shit.
You are of our people.
And I'm gonna go be like a leopard.
I'm Shonda Rhimes.
Huh?
And this.
I'm gonna go be a leopard. What? I'm gonna go be teach. Let me teach you how to be funny. I'll teach you how to be funny. It goes like this. Leopard. See. See. See what I did there? The whole setup. Holy shit. Still pissed off. Mad. I made a decision out of fear. One of the best bands ever. Seriously, I'm pissed off. And this guy is too. Boom, holla. You're like, okay, is that another setup? For Emmett Till? What? What the fuck are you talking about? Are you resident and dazzling in your way? Are you writing a book about Emmett Till, the 14-year-old kid that was killed and kicked off the civil rights movement? Holy shit, did you just rep that, right? Boom. The blood of Emmett Till, I just saw that on C-SPAN. Holy shit, when you get old like me, the only thing you want to see is Emmett Till. Come on, guys, we need to talk about this story. Resin in a, dazzin' in a. Seriously, I made a decision out of fear. It pissed me off and it dealt with photography. And I like Feminoji. Wait, Feminoji. Okay, really, I'm pissed off. And it goes back to this. Okay, I gotta just, let's talk about Emmett Till. This is a really good book you guys need to watch or read or wait till it comes out on TV, because Timothy Tyson is talking about a very important thing. Okay. Stick it, swing. Okay, boom. I just got to turn the music off and go to Emmett Till. Saw this on C-SPAN. Yes, that's a sign of getting old when you want to start getting away from all the propaganda, all the faux news, all the MSNBC, CNN, and you just want to see real stories. The blood of Emmett Till. This guy's Timothy Tyson. He wrote about a story that I talked about the Emmett Till and how Emmett Till literally kicked off the civil rights movement. And then, of course, I riffed about federally protected statuses and how they are very, very important. And these are the things that old people talk about, and Emmett Till and federally protected statuses. And today, even I made a decision out of fear. I made a decision out of, I went to this thrift store. I see this beautiful picture, this portrait. It was taken in an orphanage in Burma by a local photographer. And it was a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful piece of art for $5. And I didn't buy it. A picture. I did not buy a single picture. Fear of man, dude. What would people think? Anyway, holy shit. Now let me go back to when I used to be brave. Remember this?
Okay, here I go. One more time.
Remember this? This is very meta, by the way. See this? Is comedy becoming too PC? Going for jokes, round two. This Fibonacci nigger. He gets jokes. Shit, he gets jokes. Fibonacci nigger. Out there on the PCH doing things that make him feel brave, following his heart because he doesn't know if he's gonna live.
Comedy night, Monday nights, open mic night again. You know what?
This is what bravery looks like.
I like to get up there. I got jokes.
UFC, there's my jokes right there. Look at that. I'm living in that truck.
Comedy store. Not sure how long I'm gonna be in LA, so I thought I'd do it. Man, you know, I heard somebody say once, is it's never too late to dream another dream.
It's never too late.
I'm going to get up there and do it just because I'm scared. Man, I tell you, that's
look at this. Check this out. Watch
comedy,
this.
It's a hard thing. It's the comedy art form, in my opinion. It's one reason why I love it.
This guy's awesome.
You know, if you can get up there and make people laugh. I think the Bible even talks about laughter as a good medicine.
Look at this.
It's
look at that.
Holy thing,
11 dude. Views.
I don't know. Like I said, some people like the UFC where they just have to go get hit in the face. I have to go to comedy.
I have to go tell jokes. Let me look at this. Look at this. Another comic. Great comic. Joe Rogan. Look at this. Look how many views he's getting. 563 on the Wim Hof 712. Holy shit, that guy's brilliant. Still pissed off, man. I should have bought that picture. I made a decision out of fear. Nature lover, dad, brave, trader, teacher, book reader, cannabis advocate, hashtag MRA, photographer, newbie comic, YouTuber. I love life. I'm gonna go be brave. Maybe I should write a book. Do what this guy did. Seriously. It's an important story. Thank you, Timothy Tyson, for telling that story. One of these days, I'm going to become big and strong like Joe Rogan. I'm going to get you on my podcast, and I would love to let you tell this story to people who may not read a book, but they want it. They need it. They need this story. They need this story. And I was watching you on C-SPAN, and I saw the passion in which you were really, really embracing one federally protected status, and that is race and how court systems treat black men, or in this case, black boys, and it's amazing. Thank you for telling that story, and then I'm gonna just keep rambling, talking about the shit that I really admire, and the people I admire. Comics, brave comics, comics that are, you know, might not be commercially the most profitable or best, but holy shit, they do not get any better than this cat, except why would you name your Spears, Aries, Holla, Shot Collar, Green Dollar. And then we have the former angels. The angels that I'm beginning to really admire even after they're gone. Thank you, Bernie Mac. And then, holy shit, Fibonacci's out. Gotta keep these videos brief. Having a bad day. Tonight, yeah.